Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to another video. Today we are going to be testing the new Render AOV Node Graph that came with Blender Octane in these new versions. And this is a very powerful tool and very helpful. You can change all your render passes in real time using this new Node Graph. Okay, so let's take a look and see how it works. So to make it work, the first thing we have to do is change here on the view layer properties and passes. We have render passes. If you change from classic render passes to render AOV node graph, the first thing it's important to mention is you have to add an AOV node graph here. Okay, so to create an AOV node graph, what you have to do is change to Octane Render AOV. So here, if you press Quick Add Node Tree, it automatically generates everything you need to start creating your render passes. So this is the name, you can always rename it. So let's put Node Graph. One. Perfect. So here you can select it from here, from AOV node graph, and let's select this one here. So let's press render. And what we have here is two nodes. This one is where you're going to be changing the render passes. And this one is where you'll be adding the render passes. So we already have the beauty and the denoise beauty. So if I change to the denoise beauty, you're going to see that it's already working on the viewport here on the left. Okay, so how to add new render passes. So here we have the AOV channels where you can add the render passes. So here we have four AOV channels, but you can always add more if you click on this add input here. So you can add as many as you want. Okay, so let's try one first. So in this AOV one, let's press this plus button, and here let's add a diffuse AOV. So as you can see, anything change it because you have to change it here. Okay, so you're going to see that now we have this diffuse pass here, and if you change it, you're going to see that in the viewport is going to change as well. Okay, so the reason we are not seeing any difference between the last one, the last pass, and this one is because actually I applied a white material to the entire scene. So you can see if I change it to the beauty, you can see here we have the reflections and the diffuse doesn't have it. So it's working actually. Okay, so let's try another one. Let's try, for example, we see reflections. Again, if you change it to reflection here, you're going to see that the reflection pass now is working on the viewport. Okay, so let's try another one. Maybe the Z depth here. So same thing, I have to change it here. So let's increase the maximum Z-depth here to see some results. Let's wait a little bit, and yeah, here we go. Okay, so let's try another one. Actually, as I didn't apply like any other kind of materials, it's a little bit complicated to see all of them, but definitely you can try it out by yourself. Okay, so let me see here. Oops. See in this info here if you have anything that we can use. Wireframe maybe. Oh, same thing, have to change it here, wireframe. Here we go. Another very nice tool in this render graph node is the custom AOV. So to show you, I'm going to actually separate one part of this this scene so you can see it a little better. So this guy here, I'm going to separate it by selection. Okay, perfect. So I'm going to apply a new material to this guy here. So a new one. And down here, if you look up for custom AOV, if you change it, for example, to custom AOV 1, okay, and you add here a custom AOV, you can always search for it. So custom AOV. So let's take a look what happened. You have to change it to AOV again here. And as you can see, we created a mask. So you can create masks using the custom AOV. So this is very powerful and very helpful as well when you're making your post-processing. So you always can change it as well on the object properties. Okay, so let me show you here. If you delete, let me delete this material, I'm going to apply a new one. And if you go to the object properties and go down here on the octane settings, we have custom AOV, the same thing. So if you change it to AOV 1, what's gonna happen is the same result. Okay, so you can add custom AUVs by using the materials or using the object property. And of course, guys, if you press render, I show you, just put, you know, 50. You press F12 to render it. Go. Let's wait a little bit to reach the 50s. Gonna pause. Okay, so the render is done. If you change here, you're going to see all the passes we added on this new node graph. So it's very nice, right? So guys, I'll be recording a lot of different videos explaining new features, Blender 3.0, new features of Octane, all the things that are coming out. So stay tuned, guys. And yeah, that's it. Enjoy your day, enjoy your week, and thank you very much.